Hey guys, this is Carlos. Thank you for following my YouTube channel. And if you're new, make sure you subscribe and check out some future videos that I'll be making. Go through my older videos that I have too. I'm one of the founding members of the El Paso Drone Hive. And we're a local group here in El Paso that gather once a month. We encourage compliant drone flying in the complicated airspace here in El Paso. We have a military base and a good size airport, and so and it's really central, so we need to make sure that when you're out flying drones, you know exactly what you're doing, you know the airspace and all the rules. And so that's what we encourage for the El Paso Drone Hive. Anyhow, one of our members approached us, and he was out flying in a local mountain range here, and he got a little too close and hit some real tall shrubbery and took a spill. His Mavic Pro got stuck up in the mountain, and he asked us if we could help him recover it. So we assembled the Drone Hive admin team, also the drone recovery team. And we got together and met out there on site at the crash, near the crash site. And so Jorge shared a picture with us. It was an image of his DJI app showing us where he kind of lost connection, his flight path. And then he also shared a video here that you see. Of course, it was kind of late when he was still out there trying to think of what or how to recover his drone. It got dark on him, and it was actually a good thing because he was able to get the drone's general location with the lights still on before the battery died. And so that really helped us kind of get a general vicinity of where the drone was in reference to the mountainside there where it crashed.
Alright, so we're currently on a drone search and rescue. This big mountain you see right here is what we're gonna find.
I mean, I see that control.
Two drones in the air. Yeah.
And it's gonna take us about 30-40 minutes to get up there.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we should go.
Trying to find out where the trail starts.
Take a picture.
Yeah. Let's go. So right there where you see the phantom, there's a Mavic creeping up behind it. That's where the drone is. We have a couple payload systems we're gonna try as well. Scoop it up. Ready? Let's go.
Are you being hesitant?
Nah, I'm recording. We're about to climb right now. We got three drones in the air. There's the Mavic. Carlos, Dan, and Chris, and we're off. Got the hiking gear and everything. So there's Mike G climbing it. He looks pretty tired. I can see him taking a seat. On the other hand, George has now reached the stage of doubt. sure if you can go any further. I would say they're about 150 feet away from where we think the drone is. Of how far they've gone.
So here I'm taking up the Phantom and I'm getting some footage of Mike Garrett up there. He's already looking for the drone. You know, this is a lot harder than I personally initially thought. I figured we had a general vicinity, we could go up there and take a look and kind of find it right away. And we had an idea of trying to hook it with one of the other drones and bringing it down, but we just couldn't find it. We were scanning and looking at the reference video, but we just couldn't locate it. It was pretty camouflaged with all the terrain there. So Mike went ahead and went up. Mike Garrett went up and he hiked it up there and he started looking for the drone. So at this point, you're gonna notice Mike waving me down, and he's already located the drone. There he is on the right hand side, and he picks up the drone.
Speak up a little bit, man. It's a what?
What?
Are you good?
Yeah,
need an ambulance?
No, I'm good. I need some water.
Nah, it's actually not a lot harder than it looks, because it looked hard. That's why I didn't go up.
Yeah, I can see you're a spectator.
Yeah, but you know my knee, man. I got a knee issue.
Yeah, whatever you gotta tell yourself.
Hey, where you going? This way. Hey, let's take a look at it. You see it?
There's appears to be minimal damage. It's just a camera, a little scuffed up right here.
Is the gimbal fine?
The gimbal appears okay. This leg was a little bit damaged. I just put it back into place.
Just the landing leg, no big issue.
Landing leg, for sure it's gonna get new props. Oh yeah. Well.
Yeah.
So Jorge put in a fresh battery and she fired right up. Happy ending here. Everything seemed to function. We actually, when we were out there, when he was out there testing, I noticed a white thing moving on the mountainside, and it was a goat. And there was a goat out there on Trans Mountain. And so this video here was captured with the Mavic that we had just rescued. Or should I say Mike just rescued? Make sure to check out these other videos.